fuck up the price of coke up. I just hit them with the low cut, then call my folks up. Somebody about to get poked up, go call a tow truck. All that talking out your neck might just get your throat cut. This a Mack truck, not a black truck. When we move, tell them back up. Click, click, clack, duck. Hella bands, pull up stashed up. Super facts up. All you bitches, Rosa Parks. Uh-oh, get your ass up.
Hello guys, so welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I made a video. I apologize for that. I've been so busy. Just started a new job. Moved back home from school. So I really haven't had any time to really sit down and make a video. Don't mind those dead flowers in the back. Those are my sister's from her birthday. But so yeah, I'm gonna be doing a WIG video today and I hope that you guys enjoy it. Without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Today I'm gonna be working with a curly wig. This is the package that it came in. Kind of simple, whatever. And then it came in here. So this is 12 inches, as you can see. They usually put a sticker on here to indicate the length of the hair that you got. And this hairnet thingy. I got this wig like, I wanna say last week or the week before that. So I really haven't touched it since I've gotten it. So let's take it out. It's really cute. I've seen it on, well, first thing, this thing is already kind of pre-plugged. So I got this from Amazon. All the wigs that I've been ordering lately, I've gotten from Amazon, and I cannot complain because they have been good quality, like to the T, good quality. So I have no complaints when it comes to these wigs. And I'm pretty excited about this one, but they plucked the freak out of this thing, y'all. Like the parting is great. I'm not even gonna touch that. So this is it. This is the whole entire front. And I am in love. It has three clips, two in the front, one in the back, and then you have the elastics right here to tighten or loosen it to your head size. And so yeah, I'm gonna get started on this. So I'm just gonna place the wig on my mannequin head really quick so that I can kind of see if I need to tweak it. I think I'm gonna pluck just a little bit more, like on the hairline, just for that more seamless. It's like already done a good job, but I feel like it's done much. I feel like it looks better on one side than the other side. Like this side is more plugged, and you know, than this side. So I think I'm just gonna fix that and then go in with my foundation and do the lace, tint the lace and all of that before I put it on my head. Okay, so I'll probably go over some of the products that I'm gonna be using in this video first before I get started, just so you can have a clue. So I'm gonna be using my olive oil hair wrap mousse. Secondly, I'm going to be using this new product to lay it down, and it is the olive oil fix it grip gel. I've been really like seeing this on a lot of YouTubers videos when doing their hair, and I decided to give it a try on my last wig. And when I tell you guys, this stuff don't play no games. I mean, it's kind of still a little bit on here and they have not moved, but this stuff do not play any games. Like, it doesn't, you know, leave that white residue. It doesn't, you know, you can apply it even before, you know, it fully dries when it's tacky, and it's so good, y'all. Like, I'm not even kidding. And it is for, it says that it's for wig and weave application. So get into this, please. You can see I'm just going to put the mousse on the area at the front because this is what I'm gonna be really working with the most. So apply a good bit of that so that you can push it back and all of that good stuff. Get it into position to be plucked. It's okay if you put a lot because this stuff right here doesn't really do much to your hair. It just really helps to set it, you know. It doesn't make it hard or anything like that. It just really helps to set it. So once I get it like this, I'm going to use my brush right here that still has weave in it, and then I'm going to brush that backwards. Let me clean this. That blonde wig kind of sheds, but whatever. So I'm just gonna brush it back like that so I can get an idea of where I need to pluck it a little bit more, or where it's good at, or whatever. So yeah, like that. As you can see, this side is pretty good, but I'm just still gonna go in just to make it more to my comfort. You can see this side is a little bit more bulky, and I just want to make it even as possible. But the part is good. Oh, part is great. Like, that's true scalp, honey. But yeah, I'm just gonna pluck that real quick, and then I'll be back with the final results of the plucking. Okay, now that I'm done plucking to my liking, you can kind of see the more natural the natural look that I was kind of going for. Here, oh snap, here I just laid out the pre-plucked parts, because they only really, when they say pre-pluck, they only really take like a line of the hair, pull it out, and then pluck it forward. They don't usually pluck behind that, but and that's the part that looks bulky, because it's like, okay, pre-plucked and then a straight line of hair, like, no. So that's really like the only thing that I would say I had to fix. Or when it comes to like these kind of wigs, you have to really like go in and put it to your perfection. But yeah, so far I like that. Whatever, my hair is kind of already braided from my last wig video. I'm in my last wig, so I don't think I'm gonna touch it any more than what's already going on here. I think I'm just gonna go straight in to applying my glue. And it doesn't really take that much to just go around your forehead. You really only need it like here. So that's the good thing. So I'm just gonna take some, like a good generous amount, this much, and then just kind of go around my forehead with it. My hair, my baby hairs and all of that is already kind of pushed back from yesterday when I had on the wig, or last night, whatever, whenever I put it on. So I'm just kind of letting it air dry and all of that. And while this is air drying, I'm going to go in with my wig and take my powder and kind of tint the lace a little bit more to fit my skin tone and all of that. So yeah. Okay, so what I use for tinting my lace, I just used my bronzer. Well, I don't really use this bronzer. It's like really my exact skin tone, so it's no point of ever using it. So I just use this bronzer by Wet n Wild. It's perfect for me because it is my exact skin tone. And then I use this like little fluffy brush that I only use for my wig. And then I just take it, flip it inside out, and then put it on there. Before I put it on, and yeah, I got some of it on the wig, but that's okay. I mean, it actually looks kind of cute, but it's okay. I can always get that out. Oil, and put that on the, again, on the root, and brush that back. This helps take out the dye, coming down the dye, the powder on your lace too. But yeah, I'm just gonna use that to push that back so that I can put my wig on without any like baby hairs and all of that like in my way. It just helps. So yeah, let's put this on. Get the clip right there in the back. Okay, good. So I'm gonna pin this back. Pin these two pieces back. And do you see what I mean? This is giving me scalp already. I'm gonna let this dry a little bit more before I go in and put it down to melt it. So yeah. What was I just using? And where did I put it? Okay, whatever. So I'll put it back in there. Okay, so yeah, like I'm just gonna let that dry a little bit more and get a little more tacky and all of that before I put it down. So I'm gonna go grab my scissors and stuff so that I can cut the lace and stuff. But y'all, scalp, this is giving me life, like, already. I'm excited. Okay, I'll be right. Okay, pull this forward onto my hairline. Hold this and then get my clips. Clip it. Hold that. Clip it on this side. And, okay, now I'm gonna take my comb and kind of just press that in like that, pull it back. Like this. So go ahead and start that melting effect. Like this, if you can see what I'm doing. So like that, and then I'll take the back of it, like this smooth part, and just kind of brush that. We'll smooth it over. Okay. And now I'm gonna lay it. Okay. I'm gonna lay it with my paper thingy, and just, I usually fold it because there's really no need of using the whole big strip. So I usually fold it like this, lay it, and then tie it in the back. Okay, like this. Okay. So while this is drying and all of that good stuff, I am going to start my makeup. Okay, so now since I'm done with my makeup, it's time to get into this. So first I'm gonna take it down and style it and everything. Honestly, I think I like it better dry before I go and put all of that wetness and stuff in it. So I think I'm just gonna leave it dry for right now, but I love it dry now. I really do. It's like this one part that's kind of uneven, but whatever. I guess it's supposed to be like a feather effect, but I don't know. But I like it though. I like it though. I mean, I feel like I should cut this, but then again, I don't know. Like, is it supposed to be like that? Like, I don't know. It's just really like a long piece. But it's right here though. I don't know, but I like it. Let's get into it. Like, y'all, I'm so scared to take this lace off. But let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Because it's enough anticipating. Let's go ahead and do it and get out of the way. Honestly, first of all, let's just talk about the makeup. I think that this is going to be my new everyday makeup look. And these lashes though, like, usually I think, oh, because they're big and long, that I'm not gonna like them, but bitch, I love them. So let's just get this video done before I go and on Snapchat and forget that I even, you know, I really like it puffed out, but I don't like this unevenness. So I'm just like, should I cut it? I don't know, I'm scared. But I think I am though, because this is like hella uneven. Like that, yeah, that looks so much better, because I don't know what the goal was. Cut it upwards. I don't know what the goal was for that even part, but no, it was not cute. But yes, let's get into this look. Okay, now is the part where we gotta cut it off and whatever. This is the part that I always hate. And I don't know why. So let me just cut that, because it's already kind of like falling down, whatever. Y'all, if I did not have on the lace, you would not be able to see it. Oh my fucking God. Let's get into it. And I don't think I'm even gonna do any baby hairs, because y'all, I promise you, when you do the bronzer and it's your exact color, it's gonna look so freaking good. Okay, y'all. Okay, I'm sorry. I keep on going back between my video and then Snapchat, because it looks so good. Okay, let me just cut it and stop playing so I can go ahead and get my pictures in. Because, boo, yes. Like, is this the day that I want to take pictures? Because I will go outside. Period. But yeah, so I'm just gonna take my scissors and cut it. Let's just get into this. This is always like the make or break. I promise you. And if it breaks, I'm just gonna have to say whatever with it. I kind of like to, I should have started from the back. And I'm gonna cut this. Ooh, shoot, that glue, that thing be stuck, okay? I just wanna make sure I get that big. I mean, dang, can you cut? The bad boy wasn't trying to come out. So I'm just gonna go in and that's gonna go away whenever I go in with my alcohol and stuff. But like, yeah. Like, yes. Like, yes. Because When the sun shine, when shine together. Okay, let me drop my phone. So I'm just gonna go in with my wipe, whatever, and just kind of press that down. Like, don't really like wipe, but just kind of like press down. And yeah, my glue. Go in and put some on top. Yeah, that makes a difference. Put some on top and let that do its thing or whatever. Go in over here, kind of tint that or whatever, just to make it look a little bit more natural. A little baby hair or whatever. I think I should do a baby hair right there. But you can kind of see it looks more natural when you go in and put that to make it look like it's your actual root. But it can turn into a little baby hair, whatever. But I do like to go in and do that extra step though. And then I'll take one more. One more of my strips and put that around my hair. Yeah, and then let that dry. And then we'll be good, y'all. We'll be good. I'm so happy how this turned out. Like, oh, let me fold it. I keep forgetting. Like, y'all. Like, I didn't think it was gonna turn out this good because it was my first time dealing with a short wig like this. So I'm just gonna let that do its thing while I... Y'all can cry right now, but I'm not. But yes, I'm gonna let that do its thing real quick. And okay, so this is the final review, final look of this wig. And y'all, I am so freaking happy with how it came out. Like, you do not understand how bad I am at wigs, especially melting a wig. And if I can give my 100 honest truth, girl, people already rolling in on the snap, but if I could get my honest truth, I feel like when doing wigs, you do not always need the freaking ball cap method. Like, I promise you, those people who take the time out to do the ball cap method, to cut only this piece, sew it down for this type of wig, you're wasting time. You're wasting time. Don't do it no more. Stop. Like, this is so good. Like, this is so cute. Like, I'm scalped down, honey. I'm melted down. I am living for this wig. Specifically, bitch, at any time. Like, I just had to say it. But y'all, I don't even want to wet it. I don't even want to put no curl to it. Like, this is already giving me life, but I like the volume. To me, I love big hair. When it's too straight, I feel like it just really shows my face a little bit more than I would like. But this is giving me volume. This is giving me life. This is giving me bad girl vibes. Period. This lip. This is my first time doing the lip. And y'all, I'm about to carry me around a pencil and a freaking clear gloss every day. I mean, that's just period. But yeah. But yeah, y'all. That's it. But yeah, to close out this video, I will put the link and everything in the description box for you. For the wig that I got, this price that I paid for this wig, this is well over, you know, quality of the price. Like, this, I ain't telling them to boost up the price, but this is a good wig for how much I paid for it. Like, honestly, like, it really is. It's soft, it feels natural, and it doesn't give off that super shiny fake wig look. Like, but yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on this video and share it just in case you got a girl that's wanting to, you know, do a first time kind of wig thing. So Thank you so much again for watching this video, and see you next time.
Woke up the price of coke up. I just hit them with the low cut, then call my folks up. Somebody about to get poked up, go call a tow truck. All that talking out your neck might just get your throat cut. This a Mack truck, not a black truck. When we move, tell them back up. Click, click, clack, duck. Hella bands, pull up stashed up. Super facts up. All you bitches, Rosa Parks. Uh-oh, get your ass.